Murtz Jaffer here with another eviction interview. I am sitting here. I'm actually stunned to be sitting here with Erica. What happened?
Oh my gosh. Do you tell me? I don't even know, honestly. I feel like I blacked out through the entire thing. But no, Ryan got pulled off, saved by Canada, and I was his replacement nominee, backdoor style, which I'm not surprised by, but...
You know, in your first HOH, you made a really strong move. I was like, oh my gosh, look at this girl. She's there to win, you know, backdooring Veronica. Next time you were HOH, it was a total role reversal. You know, it was Marin and Ryan. You know, I looked at it and I was like, well, why them? Like, they're no threat to you. Yeah. So can you explain the logic behind that second HOH reign?
I think it was a mix of just HOH exhaustion, honestly. But also, I was trying to play a little more of a low-key game and a little more long-term. And I don't think I took a correct read of the house. Because at the time, now looking back, I'm like, why didn't I put Dayla up? And of course, that's going to be a question that I ask myself a lot where I'm like, oh, if only you'd put Dayla up. But at the same time, that is what I truly thought was the best game move at the time. Was not, but it was, did the best with what I could.
I want to talk a little bit more about Dayla. What was your relationship like with them? And like, were you ever really allies? Because it sort of seemed out of left field last night.
Yeah, I think we were and we weren't. It was one of those things where we could recognize each other's targets and understand that we needed each other to a certain extent to stay in the game because we were shields for each other in a way. But I knew that if there was an opportunity to take the shot, either of us would have taken it. So I can't even be upset, really, because I would have done the same thing if I was in her shoes.
When I was watching the show, I'm like, who is Erica really aligned with? It seemed like you had good relationships with, like, everyone. So what I'm curious about is, like, sort of what was your end game strategy? Who were you going to go to the end with? How would that have played out had you still been in the house?
I would have loved, in an ideal world, to make it to the end with Johnny and Will. Like, for me, those were people that I truly thought I could trust. If not Will, then Johnny all the way. Like, Johnny was my dude in the house for sure.
You had what I believe is the most fiery exit of all time. You know, it's right up there with, like, Cody walking on the table. I don't think I've ever seen anybody throw up the bird. So tell me, what was going through your head? What was going through your head when you were walking up those stairs?
Honestly, I was just in such a daze and trying to process everything that happened. And then I don't know what went through me, what happened as soon as I took a look at Dayla. I was like, absolutely not. And just had this like inner rage and frustration, both with them, the situation, and myself a little bit, where I was like, oh, like, why didn't I take the shot when I had the chance? So it was just all of those raw emotions coming to the surface. Unfiltered, which, I mean, they probably should have been a little filtered, but that's exactly how I was feeling in that moment.
You know, every season in Big Brother, there's sort of two ways to play. I'm going to call it the Erica strategy, which is just like go hard and win everything, or the Paris and Maddie strategy, which is like just fly under the radar, float, but get to the end. Yeah. When you look back, do you sort of like regret not doing it that way? Because they're still in the house and your like over the top style of play, win everything, has you sitting here.
Yeah. No, for me, unless I'm sitting first or second, I didn't really care when I went out, to be honest, as long as I was proud of the gameplay I did while I was in the house. Because for me, fourth place, 10th place, it doesn't really make a difference in my eyes, as long as I can look back at the season, know I did my absolute best, know I pushed myself to my limits, and be proud and have people be like, you like went out there and beasted it. And that makes me so happy to be able to like make an impact like that.
How much of an impact did Hamza's departure have on your game?
Hamza leaving broke my heart, honestly. And I think that was one of the reasons I probably slowed down, because had he been in there, he would have probably talked me right into being like, absolutely not, you're not slowing down, what do you think you're doing? And so losing that kind of motivating factor, that voice, was huge. I was just sad that week, honestly.
Is it possible to win Big Brother Canada without telling a single lie?
No, in my eyes, absolutely not. You have to at least stretch the truth a little bit. And I think the difference for me comes down to people who have no problem lying through their teeth and those that it actually kind of like eats them up a little bit. Because for me, I've told my fair share of lies in the house, but it was never comfortable. And the people who can just look at someone, lie to them straight in the face and then feel proud of it, it's just not my style of gameplay personally.
Okay, so I want to pretend that I'm Kaela right now, and this is like after the show, and this is the first time that you're seeing me. How is that conversation going to go?
I think once the show is done...
No, but you got to talk to me like I'm Kaela, okay? Kaela right now, yes. Okay, so, Erica, I'm really sorry. It's just a game.
Yeah, honestly, you're right. It is just a game. I respect the game move. It had to happen. It's unfortunate that you felt the need to lie straight to my face about it. If when you had pulled me aside into the pantry and said, girl, I got to take the shot, it's now or never, I would have respected you a lot more as an overall game player. I respect the move, but it doesn't mean I respect the way you went about it.
That's pretty classy. I wanted more of, like, you know, the exit.
Screw you. No, because that's the thing. And at the end of the day, I knew if she is a smart game player, she had to take the shot at me. And it just shows that she is. I hate that it's used as a resume builder for her because it's like so irritating. But still, in this case, it's like you had no other choice.
You think she's going to play that? You know, like, oh, I'm the one who got rid of Erica.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. That's the only thing she's done this season besides get a boyfriend.
Twists, you know, I have a very, like, specific opinion about, like, twists in the game. I want to know what you think about that, because obviously, like, part of the rules of Big Brother are there are going to be twists, like the one we saw last night. Do you think twists belong in the game?
I think they do, because it shakes it up, and it keeps things fresh, and it keeps things interesting, especially if the house is falling into kind of a predictable pattern. But as someone who's in the house, no, because that's terrifying. You can't prep for something like that, and there's no way of surviving. Like, I wouldn't have survived a twist like that regardless, because that was just... It just set it up perfectly for me to be evicted. So right now, in like a sad state, I guess, I'm like, no, I hate that that was even a twist. But as a fan who would be rooting for the underdog, yeah, Ryan should stay for sure. And it was it shook the game up, that's for sure. I'm excited to see what happens next.
And finally, what's the best part about being on Big Brother Canada?
I think it's being able to push yourself past your limits and accomplish things that you never thought you could. And something as easy as like being as seemingly as easy as being a have not for 2 weeks in a row. I'm the person who like sits on the couch and I'm like, you're fine. Why are you crying? It's just slob, like whatever. But then you're in there and it's mentally draining and exhausting. And to overcome something like that, it just shows how much you can do as a person. Sorry.
Now, before I let you go, one of my favorite scenes this season on Big Brother Canada was when Andrew was like staring at you on the couch. Can you give me an example of like what that cut eye was like? And how did that make you feel?
Great. No, it made me so uncomfortable. I was like, you can blink. Like, you can 100% blink. You can still try to be intimidating while blinking. It's okay. But yeah, there was a lot of moments where people just decide, like, the alpha male stare down. It was a little uncomfortable.
I like it. All right, Erica, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Me.